Hello. I get the question a lot. Is deep breathing dangerous? And I will explain in this video yes or no, and it has to do with something that is called the Bohr effect. Now, within some breathing schools, more Buteyko kind of breathing or oxygen advantage, the message is that you want to breathe light to breathe right. Breathe as little as possible so you keep your CO2 levels high and therefore you have a more optimal oxygen distribution. Yeah, this will all be clear at a certain moment. Now, other techniques like Soma breathing, TT breathing, Wim Hof method breathing is about in, out, very deep breathing and then a breath hold, the so-called deep breathing breath hold techniques. Now, what happens if we breathe deeper? This is important, it's gonna take no time. I'm not gonna show a graph. This is not a deep science session. It's pretty straightforward. When we breathe deeper, of course, we add oxygen to our bloodstream. Yeah, but a normal person has like 98% oxygen saturation, means you only add 2%. Now, what else is happening apart from adding that last bit of oxygen to your bloodstream? You blow off a lot of CO2. This is, by the way, why you can hold your breath so long in the breath hold, in the retention, because you blow off so much CO2, and this is the breathing trigger. But that's a bit of a sidestep, so let me get back to the story. We breathe out a lot of CO2. Now, if in our blood, we have our lungs, blood, muscle tissue. If in our blood, the CO2 level is extremely low, say 50% of the normal CO2 level, you get automatically a CO2 flow because of diffusion from your muscle tissue to your bloodstream. So the CO2 level, simply said, the CO2 level in your muscle tissue goes down as well. Now, is that a good thing? Well, it depends on it. If it's always like that, it's unhealthy. But if you do it temporary, you know, like 20 minutes of breathing session, it is actually a very healthy thing. So what happens if our CO2 levels in our muscle tissue is going down? With lower CO2 levels, the ability of the oxygen molecules to let go of the red blood cell and actually go into the muscle goes down as well. Yeah, so too low CO2 levels will result in your muscle tissue not taking enough oxygen, not taking up enough oxygen. And so a lot of CO2, because you have been sporting or maybe you have something that is not well in your body, is unhealthy, but too little is unhealthy too. Now, this is called the Bohr effect. The Bohr effect is officially, you know, the affinity of tissue to take up oxygen. When CO2 levels are too low, your muscle tissue doesn't take up oxygen. Now, is that an unhealthy thing? Well, it's very simple. If you would be deep breathing, like almost hyperventilating the whole day, and always blowing off your CO2, it would be an unhealthy thing. But because you do it temporary, it's not chronic deep breathing, but in a breathing session with a breath hold, it's actually a very healthy thing. Because what happens if you breathe deeper 30, 40, 50, 60 times? CO2 level goes down, then the oxygen goes to your bloodstream, but the affinity of your red blood cells to release that oxygen to your muscle tissue goes down with that CO2, right? It's a bit weird. Now, CO2 goes down in your bloodstream, CO2 goes down in your muscle tissue, therefore oxygen take up, oxygen goes down in your muscle too. So basically when you do deep breathing, your blood is completely 100% saturated with oxygen, but in your muscle tissue it actually goes down. And here comes the magic. Yeah, if you would do this always, unhealthy. But because you do it for, say, 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes, something like that, and then you do a breath hold, what happens in the breath hold? Your body keeps on producing energy, CO2 levels go up in the muscle tissue as well. And at a certain moment, the affinity to release that oxygen has reached its level. And while your blood is 100% saturated, all that oxygen flows into your cells. Isn't that beautiful? So, this is simply explained the Bohr effect. And to summarize with the question, is deep breathing dangerous? The answer is pretty simple. If you do it in a breathing session with a breath hold, it's very healthy. If you would always be deep breathing, it would be very unhealthy. That's it. If you like this video, please also actually like it and subscribe to this channel if you want to be updated on stuff like this. Thank you very much. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.